press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Students, good morning to all. In the last video, we discussed about the vector addition in vector algebra. The two methods we have taken, tip-tail method and triangle of vector addition. So in both, the points we have learnt is that commutative law is valid. A plus B equal to B plus A. You will get the resultant with both magnitude and direction. But I can show here the parallelogram law, the third one, parallelogram law. The same, if this triangle itself you slide and place here, you will observe the parallelogram. Otherwise, the two vectors which we have taken as A and then another vector B, in the law of triangle of vectors or the tip-tail method, tail of the first we joined to the tip of the second and you got the resultant R. That is from A to B to C. Is a resultant A plus B. Instead of that, I can write first B, this first B, and I taken A, then the resultant is again tail to that point, is R. Now resultant is same. The shape what you are seeing is a parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other. A to A, B to B, this may be D. You can move from A to D, D to C, or A to B, B to C, but the resultant is from A to C, which we have taken here resultant as R. This is a law of parallelogram of vector addition. As like we have defined or given the definition or statement of triangle of vector addition. If the two vectors which are to be added, taken both in magnitude and direction as the two sides of a triangle. The closing side or the third side of the triangle taken in the opposite order, closing side, opposite order, gives you the resultant of or the vector sum of the two vectors A and B both in magnitude and direction. Similarly, we have to have the statement for this parallelogram law of vector addition. If the two vectors which are to be added, taken as two sides of a parallelogram, two adjacent sides particularly, with a common point, AB, as two adjacent sides of a parallelogram passing through a common point. Now, if I complete this parallelogram, you will get a diagonal, which we call it as a diagonal. Diagonal, there are two diagonals, but I taken the diagonal which is passing through the common point of B and A, passing through the common point of B and A, passing through the tail of both in this, represents both in magnitude and direction the vector sum of two vectors. That is the statement of parallelogram law of vector addition. If the two vectors to be added are represented both in magnitude and direction as the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram passing through a common point, two adjacent sides of a parallelogram passing through the common point, then the diagonal of the parallelogram passing through this common point represent both in magnitude and direction the vector sum of A and B, is the statement. By the knowledge of triangle, you can understand this. Always remember, in vector addition, the third side must be, that is closing side must be in the opposite order. I told resolution of vector we take later. Concept of Lami's theorem I given you in the last class, but details under equilibrium we discuss. And this parallelogram law, you understood, analytical method, we have to get the expression for resultant magnitude and direction both. We go detail afterwards. Now these laws, what we have discussed, tip tail method, triangle law or parallelogram law of vector addition, these are holds good even including Lami's theorem only for two vectors. If we had to add more than two vectors, then we come to polygon law of vector addition. So in this, I told in geometrical construction, either you can go with the tip tail method or you have to construct the structure in such a way that any order you can select the vectors, but it should go in a proper order so that the closing side and opposite order, closing side and opposite order must be kept in mind very carefully. Let us come to this fourth one, law of vector addition as a polygon law. For example, consider the vector A and another vector may be B, third vector may be C and another vector D. So I have to add here four vectors I take, not only three, four, five, any number of vectors can be taken, but if you are following tip tail method or the proper order you have to select. Just I take this translation of vector you take here. So this vector is A. This vector is A. Then come to this B vector. This vector, that tail is added to the tip of this vector A. Now it may be A, B and now C. Instead of C, I will take D, because if taken that side, it becomes difficult to go. If D, now the vector D, again you see the vector D tail, tip of B, we join to this as a D. Now vector C, tail of that tip to the D, so this becomes C. Now this is the tip of the last vector. Now it is the tail of the first vector, if I call it as E. What I have to do? Tail to tip join according to this. According to the geometric method, you see vector A to B to C to D to E, we moved in the anti-clockwise direction. What this is? Closing sign. This is the closing side. Order is opposite. These two in mind you have to carefully remember. Any number of vectors you have to add carefully so that you can get the resultant. How? You have to tail off the first tip of the last, you join with a vector. In the tail to tip order, tail to tip order, then you will get the resultant, opposite order and closing side. It is in the anti-clockwise direction, we have taken in the clockwise direction. So that this is the vector addition, what we got vector R, if I told here. This vector R is nothing but vector A plus B plus B plus C equal to vector R, we got it. So let us add the two, A, B. Have you got A and B added? Tail of the first and tip of the last. What this represents according to you? What is that is representing? This what represents? It is A plus B, right? A plus B. Now remove this. It is equivalent to these two. The vector is tail and tip of this. This is the vector A plus B. Now A plus B to be added with D. Now you join this. direction. Now what this is? A plus B plus D. Now I remove these three. I have this vector which replacing all these three. One vector A plus B plus D is this vector. A to D is acting. Then add this C. What this represents is the resultant. A plus B plus, what I have to do? A plus B plus D plus C. A plus B plus D plus C I did. C I did here. So this is how the parallelogram to polygon law, not only four vectors, three, four, five, including two vectors also, we can add and get this. Remember one thing, the law says in polygon also, given vectors to be arranged in one certain order, one order with both magnitude and direction without disturbing that. You can transfer or slide those vectors and kept in one order, and closing side of the polygon taken in the opposite order, represent the resultant of these vectors, sum of all the vectors given. Two things, closing side, opposite order. If it comes in the same order, then it becomes equilibrium, equilibrant vector. The net vectors effect becomes zero. Suppose if it is comes in the same direction, it becomes zero. So however, I hope you are followed at this stage, what we have taken. So let us move with this. I can show that also if you are taken in the same order, what happens. If you are started from AB, suppose if it is AB vector. So let us plus BC vector, BC, CD plus CD plus DE plus EF, if I taken like this. EF, EA should be zero, null vector. You come to know that starting point A we returned, AB, BC, CD, DE, EA. We return to the back position. Let similar terms you cancel here, B to B, C to C, D to D, E to E. What is remained is first A to A. A to A joining is a null vector. Suppose if you taken in the same order, all the vectors come in the same order, then total effect of the vector becomes zero. Null vector, no magnitude, arbitrary direction remains. Suppose if I read on the right side of that, these vectors, then this become AB plus BC plus CD plus DE is equal to minus EA. Minus EA is nothing but AE. AE become the resultant. Taken in the opposite order, converted to be resultant. Taken in the same order, become equilibrant. The total effect of all vectors becomes zero in that case. So this is very helpful in our physics. So you will learn, not at this stage, in the second PUC, so some Biot-Savart law, where you have the current element like this, is a wire, small length, carrying current I. We defined it as a current element, I into dl, current element, is a vector. So this small magnitude, if I start from this point A, these are the vectors. So I have to get the total effect of all these together. So whatever the direction, there is no, but in one order you have to place them. Each one is ideal, small element. So this wire is bent in this form. Started from A and reached the B. What is the vector sum we can get here is this. So what this is, we have taken in the clockwise, and this should be in the anti-clockwise direction. What is the value of this is integration of A to B I into DL gives you. Very simple and become physics easy once you understood this vector algebra of addition. Or not only that, I think you are followed here. I coming to the another example. Not only in proper order, this may be like this. Started from A and reached B again. So the current elements are same, may be like this. If we join them together, each is current element IDL. DL is a small length into current. So this integration of IDL becomes zero. Can come to conclusion directly because all is in the one order. Here A to B in one order, but this we have taken in the opposite order. This is moving in this order, then but it is in the anti-clockwise direction. Or not only like that, for example, started from A, moved like this one element, another element like this, another element may be like it is moved, light like this, and come and join with B. Each one is carrying the current. So this let us see now. We started from A, reached this, went like this, coming back to this position. Here, what is the total current effect is integration of IDL becomes zero. Very easy if they are coming in one order, but carefully you have to see the arrow mark. If they are returning to the same point, then the total effect of vector sum becomes zero. So such in a different style, it helps you in physics in different topics. I hope here you are understood. This we go with the resolution of vectors separately, and Lamy's theorem I discuss in equilibrium concept. And now A plus B equal to B plus A equal to R. That means one thing you come to know. I told in the beginning, a quantity may be called as a vector if it is a have magnitude, it has the direction, and it should obey the commutative law. And it also obey the associative law. I show that one now before going to the analytical method of the parallelogram law of vector addition. So I hope you are understood this. How the associative law is holds good, let us see. So let us consider the vector A and another vector B. And another vector may be C. I taken the three vectors. So to prove the associative law, let us start with A. Let it be A. When I take an A first, you have this. Join tip to tail of this. So you got this vector as B. Now we got this tail to tip is the A plus B. We started from A, added B and reached this is a tip of A plus B. It is the tail of A plus B, it is the tip of A plus B. We have to add C. The vector C is here. Tail of that tip and dist it. So what I have to join? Tail of the first vector to be joined with the tip of the last. That means from here to I join this. This is the resultant which we got. A plus B, first I taken, plus C, one we got. That R is equal to A plus B plus C. So we added A to B, then to C. This A plus B is sum of these two. This is the tail of this A plus B and tip. This is one vector. So this added and tail to the tip of the third. Now first, not need not be necessary, first we can take B and C. Let us take the B. Here the vector B I take. Vector B, then to vector C, see the tail of this tip, tail of that to tip here. How to join tail of the first to the tip of the second? This becomes B plus C. It's a single vector. This is in one order, taken in the opposite order. Now I have to add A. A is a vector I take here. Vector A. So it is the tail, I joined the tip of this. Now this is the tail and tip. Tail to tip you join. What you got is the R, where it is A plus B plus C, B plus C and A. Thus I got now A plus of B plus C. So I shown here with simple example and by geometrical construction. There are different methods of proving this. This is called as associative law of vector addition. Vector addition follow the commutative law and associative law both. It follows both. That you remember, a physical quantity can be called as a vector. It should have magnitude, it should have the direction and follow the vector algebra. Means here commutative law and associative law should holds good. Then we call it as a vector. So I hope this you are understood clearly. Now what we discussed so far is an analytical geometrical method of vector addition, taking tip tail or taking in one order the vectors and opposite order closing side concept and got the resultant both in magnitude and direction. On appropriate scale the closing side gives you the magnitude and arrow mark which we got in the opposite order will give you the direction. Now I am going for an analytical method, most useful tool of these mathematics, vector addition or subtraction, which is most oftenly used in 50% of your first PUC and 50% in the second PUC when you go to the electrostatic, electric field, magnetism, magnetic field. In all these cases, the importance you will come to know. So let us go to the analytical method, and also remember it is for the board exam I am stressed at the beginning. You have in some chapters a planar motion. So one of the derivation may be asking in your board examination, this analytical method of addition of two vectors, getting the resultant, its magnitude, expression for magnitude and also the direction. Follow it carefully without negligency. One of the most important question asking you in the board exam for 3 or 5 marks.
The second addition of vectors by analytical method. Parallelogram law of vector addition, getting expression for both magnitude and direction. Important one for 5 or 3 marks in board exam. So an important derivation, we are going to get the expression for the magnitude and direction of the resultant of addition of two vectors. Let us consider two vectors for this. One vector A representing with the A and B, and then another vector B representing C, and angle between the two vectors is a theta. So in parallelogram law, we have discussed this statement in the previous discussion. Let us take completely parallelogram. If it is a D, this represents in parallelogram the vector A, and this represents the vector B, parallel and equal in magnitude. So according to the statement, it is vector B. You know, the diagonal passing through the common point gives you the resultant as the sum of A plus B. That statement we have discussed. Statement says if the two vectors are represented as two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, both in magnitude and direction, then the diagonal passing through that common point represent both in magnitude and direction the resultant of or sum of A plus B. So the value R, we have to get its magnitude and direction. So what we have to, how to proceed, let us see. Now just we concluded the statement, how the resultant comes in case of parallelogram law. Let us now first extend this vector A extended. Drop the normal from B and call it as E. Normal I drawn from that point. Now this angle is a theta because two sides are parallel to each other, they are becoming the corresponding angles. Now in this triangle, before going to the other, in this triangle, it is a right angle triangle. You know it is opposite side by hypotenuse, BE by B gives you the sine theta, or DE means I can write B sine theta. As a magnitude, let us see the magnitude, not vector necessary. Just get the magnitude of that. B is a magnitude of the vector. DE by B, that means sin theta, or DE equal to B sin theta. Similarly, DE by B is equal to cos theta. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. This I can write as a B cos theta. So why I did this? I extended the vector A and drop a perpendicular from DE and taken this angle theta, I taken B sin theta and B cos theta. To make our mathematics easier under geometrical construction, in a right angle triangle, first step you see, in right angle triangle, ADE, in triangle, right angle triangle, ADE, ADE is a right angle triangle, apply your Pythagoras theorem. It contains R and AE plus D. According to that, I can write this whole can be AD whole square is equal to AE whole square plus DE whole square, right? According to vector algebra, Pythagoras theorem, AB square is equal to AB square plus AE square plus DE square. This triangle I have taken, this particularly, this is right angle triangle. In that triangle, we come to know this is one. What is AD square? I can come later, but AE square can be split. AE square can be split as, up to this it is A and this is B cos theta. I can write AE as this as R square, this as R square is equal to A plus this is B cos theta whole square. AE square means AB is A square plus BE is B cos theta whole square plus DE is B sin theta whole square. So let us expand this. R square is equal to A square plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta plus B square sin square theta. I hope you are A plus B whole square. A square plus B square plus 2AB plus B square sin square theta. So I club these two. R square is equal to A square plus B square, I brought out, sin square theta plus cos square theta. This plus this, sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. 2AB cos theta. But you know, sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Therefore, I can write R square is equal to A square plus B square, it become B square, plus 2AB cos theta. Therefore, I can write magnitude of resultant R is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta is the important derivation what we got here. One, magnitude of the resultant we obtained. What we did? Taken vector a, vector b, expected this as a resultant. To get this value, extended a and drawn perpendicular from b to e. And now we got the components. This side b is equal to b cos theta, adjacent side by hypotenuse, opposite side by hypotenuse as b sin theta. Right angle triangle ADE taken as AD square is AE square plus BE square. AD square is R square. AE square is A plus B cos theta whole square. This A, this is B cos theta. And DE square is B sin theta whole square. A plus B expanded. A square plus B square plus 2AB. AB means A, B means B cos theta. And square this, b square sin square theta. I brought both together as a square plus b square sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2ab cos theta. You know already sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 in trigonometry. Therefore, the answer we got, what we got is a and b are two vectors, theta is the angle between them. If you are given the three quantities, two vectors and angle between them, then you are possible to get the magnitude of that resultant. We got the expression for resultant magnitude. Suppose direction of R, direction of resultant R, let us take this as angle alpha with respect to A, R making angle with respect to A. Take the same triangle, right angle triangle ADE. In a right angle triangle ADE, what is a tan alpha? What is a tan alpha? This triangle ADE, this is angle alpha, opposite side by adjacent side. What I have to write here? DE, DE divided by AE. What is it? BE is nothing but B sin theta. B sin theta. What is A is A plus B cos theta. A plus B cos theta. Now we have got the equation. Tan alpha equal to this is equation 2. This is the alpha is the angle made by R with respect to A. With respect to A. So this is the resultant. Making an angle with respect to A is alpha. Then value of tan alpha is, see here, alpha is the angle made by resultant with respect to A. This is taken, started from B. If you are measuring angle with A, then we have to start from B. B sin theta by A plus B cos theta, knowing 3. If you know A, B and theta angle between the two, you can get the alpha where you find the direction. That our purpose is solved. We got the answer. What is the magnitude? Expression is this. We analytically got, knowing the magnitude of the two vectors and angle between them, you can get the resultant R. And similarly, if you want angle alpha, that angle made by resultant with respect to A, then tan alpha equal to B sin theta by A plus B cos theta. Alpha equal to tan inverse we can do. The numerical value something comes here. You can get the alpha value by doing tan inverse. What I shown here is for alpha with respect to A. Let us think the angle may be beta. This beta, what the changes comes is, by this observation I can write tan beta directly as, if you made with A, you started from B. If it is made with B, start from A, same relation. That means A sin theta divided by B plus A cos theta gives you the angle made by angle made by R relative to B. Angle made by R relative to B. Either with respect to B, either with respect to A, the magnitude can be assessed in two ways. This is beta is angle between R and B. Alpha is angle between R and A. So this much you have to write in case of board examination, the magnitude and getting the resultant, both. Magnitude we got A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, and angle direction of R with respect to A or R with respect to B. If R alpha B sin theta by A plus B cos theta, same triangle I shown for this. Similarly, we can show for the other tan beta equal to A sin theta by B plus A cos theta. An important derivation for board examination. With this, we have to go for the special cases. We move to the special case. Before think that, you just understand it. One of the important relation you have to remember throughout 2 years. When the vector concept comes, addition comes or subtraction comes, you have to use the same relation. So, I hope you are understood this. Let us come to the special cases taking these two equations, tan alpha and R. Have a glance, I remove it. Vector A plus B equal to resultant, its magnitude R equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, and direction alpha is equal to tan inverse of B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. That we have derived. The angle made by A with respect to B, resultant. Now the case one. Simplest theta 0 degree. The two vectors are parallel, A and B. What happens to the resultant? See, it is A square plus B square 2AB cos 0 is becoming, cos 0 is 1, A square plus B square plus 2AB can be written as A plus B whole square or become A plus B. It takes maximum value. A plus B, when the two vectors addition become maximum means when angle between them is zero, parallel to each other. What is the direction if you take alpha? Sine 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1. 0 by anything is 0. Alpha 0 means R is along A or B, whichever you take, same. Because both are acting in the same direction, resultant is also acting in the same direction. If I shift and showed here, it is the vector A, and similarly I shift here to this, I join this, become B, and sum of that two is R. That is what simple, it become A plus B whole square is A plus B, sorry. A plus B. And angle also got zero, act in the same direction. You come to know maximum value of addition of two vectors possible when they act parallel to each other. Coming to case 2, theta is equal to 180 degree. That means one vector A is acting in the same direction, but B is opposite. Now resultant become minimum root of A minus B whole square. Why? Because cos 180 is minus 1. Minus 1 means A square plus B square minus 2AB. A square plus B square minus, because cos 180 is minus, minus 2AB is A minus B whole square, and this can be written as A minus B. A minus B is minimum. What is the angle alpha is? Again, it is 0. Because sine 180 is 0. Cos 180 minus present, A minus B becomes, but 0 by anything is 0. 0 implies here slightly different meaning, because it is A, vector A, and now I join B, instead of forward I can shift to the left, shift to the left, and I can write here this is B. Now the resultant become minusing this vector become resultant R is less, but in the same direction of A, if vector A greater than B. It is along this. If A is less than B, then it is along B. That is the meaning of this. If B is greater than A, resultant comes in this direction. Now we have taken A is greater than B. Therefore, resultant, what I am saying, the difference of these two is a small value along A. But if A is less than B, B is greater, then it will be opposite. Angle between the two vectors here is 180 degree. Let come to third, theta is equal to 90 degree, orthogonal. That vector B and this vector A, angle between them is 90 degree. Now what happens to the resultant? Root of cos 90 is 0. Simply it become A square plus B square. This term vanish, 2AB cos theta vanishes. What remained is only A square plus B square, have some value. What is the angle between the two? Now if you want alpha for this, tan inverse of, this become B only, because sine 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, B by A. So if you know the value of B and A, you can get the value of alpha, angle made by resultant with A. Resultant at the A get B by A. It is the case when the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, orthogonal to each other. Let come to the fourth. Theta is equal to 60 degree. 60 degree. That this vector A and vector B, angle between them is 60 degree. Resultant become root of A square plus B square plus AB. Plus AB.
What is cos theta 60?
Is half.
Half cancels with the 2. And AB only remains. A square plus B square plus AB is the answer here. Cos theta is half. Cos 60 is half. And 2 to get cancels.
What is alpha? Tan inverse of. See, B sine theta. B sine theta sine 60 is root 3 by 2.
B root 3 by 2
divided by A plus B by 2, because cos 60 is half.
Sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Cos 60 is a common LCM.
If you take and return here, it becomes tan inverse of root 3B upon 2A plus B. Because this common LCM 2A plus B, 2 to get cancels, B root 3. So knowing the value of B and A, you can get the alpha value.
If it is at 60 degree to each other.
Let's take angle theta equal to 120. Some standard, these relations why I am showing is immediately you have to recall in problems in entrance. These angles are preferably selecting for designing the problems in entrance. So if it is 120 degree, you know this is the A and this is vector B. Angle between them is 120 degree. 120 degree. Now R is equal to root of A square plus B square minus AB. Why? You know cos 120 can be written as cos 180 minus 60. Cos 180 minus 60 is cos 60.
Cos 60 is half cancels, AB remains. But 120 is in the second quadrant, you know cos function is negative. Therefore, minus half. Cos 120 is minus half. Minus half 2 to cancels, minus sign comes, it is minus AB.
Now what happens to alpha? Tan inverse of. Sin 120 is cos 30. Sin 120 is cos 30. Cos 30 is again B root 3 by 2.
Sin 120 or sin 90 plus 30 is cos 30. 90 plus 30 cos 30, but second quadrant plus
divided by A plus, A.
Already you know it is minus half.
Therefore minus B by 2. Or tan inverse of root 3 B by 2A minus B. So these are the five standard relations I have taken here. Angle between the two. Two parallel vectors having different magnitude. What is maximum means? Become A plus B whole square. Acting parallel. A plus B. Act in the same direction of A or B. When come to theta 180, A and B are parallel, or minimum becomes A minus B, and angle is depending on whichever is greater. It follows the direction whichever is greater. If A is greater, it is in the direction of A. If B is greater, it is in the direction of B. But A and B are in opposite direction, unlike parallel vectors they are. Orthogonal vectors, 90 degree A plus B, A square plus B square, and alpha is tan inverse of B by A. And if the angle between the vectors is 60 degree, then we come to know it is R equal to root of A square plus B square plus AB. And here it is root 3B by 2A plus B, tan inverse of that. If it is 120 degree, then A square plus B square minus AB, which leads to alpha equal to tan inverse of root 3b 2a minus b. So the five important angles oftenly we are taking in problems in physics between the two vectors. Now there are some special cases of this again. I hope you are followed. Here we derived the expression for both magnitude and direction, and it got these special cases. I go to the next one. I remove now this. So now coming to the case number 6, if resultant R is perpendicular to one of the vectors, suppose the two vectors, one is A and other is B. Resultant is this. If I shifted A here, you will get this vector A. Now this combined. This is 90 degree, which is equal to alpha. Total angle is this. This is theta, and this may be called as beta. The angle between them theta is, condition A is, angle between A and B, two vectors, is obtuse. That means more than 90 degree. That is theta equal to, we are seeing, 90 plus beta. 90 plus beta gives you the total angle between A and B. And R resultant is perpendicular to smaller of the two vectors. This you have to remember clearly, which help you to solve the problems in physics easily when come to application level. If they given the conditions like this, if the resultant is perpendicular to one of the vectors, two things are true. The angle between them is more than 90 degree, and resultant is perpendicular to smaller of the two vectors. Smaller of the two vectors, alpha is 90 degree. Let us see what happens to this alpha. So alpha 90 means tan 90 degree, which is infinity, equal to b sine theta divided by a plus b cos theta. You have this, a plus b cos theta. Tan 90 infinity, b sin theta upon a plus b cos theta. If it is infinity, means this must be 0. This must become 0, because anything by 0 is infinity. Therefore, I can write a plus b cos theta is equal to 0, which suggests cos theta equal to minus a by b is the second important term. Here I shown it is more than angle. Now the second relation I brought, this theta is 90 plus beta, more than 90, and cos theta is comes to be minus a by b, the second one show. And let us see what happens to R. Resultant R equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab into minus a by b.
bb cancels, become minus 2a square. A square minus 2a square become root of a square minus 2a square plus b square. Or I can say now, resultant equal to root of become b square minus a square, simple equation.
So options we have to remember while going for application. If that is the condition, theta must be 90 plus beta, where beta is the angle made by resultant with respect to the vector b. Vector b, a plus b cos theta become minus a by b, and resultant become b square minus a square. And again you see what happens to in the triangle if I main it a, b, c, d. It is 90 degree mutually, parallel to each other. In the right angle triangle, b, a, c, d, a, c, d, a, c, d. For example, let us take this ACD. This is beta. Now in that, I can go with the three trigonometric functions. What is a sine beta?
Sine beta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse.
That means A by B. A by B. What is cos theta? Cos beta. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. R by B. What is tan beta? Opposite side by adjacent side. A by R. So these are the different relations arises when resultant become perpendicular to one of the two vectors. Angle between the vectors is more than 90 degree, obtuse angle. And vector resultant vector is perpendicular to smaller of the two vectors always. For which cos theta, angle between them if you want, cos theta is minus a by b. Minus a by b. And r is equal to become b square minus a square. And sine beta, beta is the angle between R and B. R and B, sine beta is A by B, cos beta is R by B, and tan beta is A by R. These are the important relations we have seen. The time is running, therefore I am stopping today here, because still we have to see if the two vectors are same, A equal to B, then what happens to these relations, what we have shown for different angles and alpha. That we will see in the next video, more interesting factors. With that we have to enter to the subtraction of vectors, equilibrium of vectors and resolution of vectors, the three parts before going to the multiplication. We will try in the next video. I hope today we started the different types of important vectors as axial vector, polar vectors, position vector, unit vector and displacement vectors, including modulus of vector, how to estimate the modulus of a vector. And simply we studied about the addition of vectors by geometrical methods, maybe tip-tail method or triangle law or parallelogram law or Lamy's theorem under. We gone through resolution of vectors. When we discuss the resolution, we will understand how the addition of vectors by resolution method we do it. But we started the analytical method, and one of the important derivations we did, magnitude of the resultant of two vectors addition, and also the alpha, angle made by the resultant with respect to A, we have this relation. And different cases we discussed when they are parallel, anti-parallel, orthogonal and about 60 degree, about 120 degree, what is the value of R or what is the value of alpha, angle made. And one of the conditions I brought, if the resultant is perpendicular to one of the vectors, what are the two conditions and what happens to R and sin beta, cos beta and tan beta values. Thank you. I hope you are followed. You try it slowly, understand it clearly, because most important tool and equations, not only two equations, are necessary and critical values. When theta becomes 0, 180, 60, 90, 120 are more important along with this. Whichever important relations and angles we consider, and similarly if the two vectors are equal, what happens to these values, we have to see in the next video along with subtraction and resolution of vectors. Thank you all.